Welcome to Intelsoft Institute. The first chapter of laptop chip level repair training, that is introduction to laptop parts. We will show you the laptop boards. The first chapter is an introduction to laptop boards in the laptop chip level training. Before going to the laptop boards, we must have a basic idea of desktop motherboard. So input and output. Two process, input output. We give the data and it gives the output to printer or VGA or display or VGA something portions are there. So there will be one input output. We are giving input and processing, storing on the hard disk, and all those processes are done. For that we require the different sections. So keyboard, mouse are connected through IO to the output printer. In a desktop board will look like this. You already know these things. Okay, it is single side bottom. There is a no connections, nothing is there, only pins are there. This is an dual electronics components are there. One is an SMD and one is a normal. Next, this is old motherboard and this is the latest boards. That is a i3 i5 block diagram. Here the CPU is connected with the RAM and sometimes the graphic also connected with the CPU, and graphic IC is also connected with the CPU. This is R51 bottom view and this is a top view. Top view main components are there, bottom is additional components are there. This is single chip CQ50 motherboards, that is also CPU. We are showing different boards so that you can understand their concepts. This is a CPU. This is with North Bridge, South Bridge, both combined ICs. RAM is connected with the CPU and these are the power section 1.8, 1.5, 3 watt, 5 watt, all the power sections are there. This is Sony MBX motherboard 165 top view. Okay, here also same CPU, Intel 965, graphic chips, additional memory, additional graphic chips are there. See, graphic chips, North Bridge, okay, CPU. And others graphic memory, and these are the power regulator. Where you can see the inductor, it means this is the power. Chapter 2, types of platform Intel and AMD. Sonoma platforms block diagram something like this, where is the CPU, North Bridge, South Bridge. Okay, CPU is connected with North Bridge, North Bridge connected with the RAM and output, input and PCI Express graphic. CPU thermal sensor, CPU, there is a 478 pins. CPU required a clock frequency, so near to that, that clock generator ICs give the frequency to the CPU. This is your CT1, that is a V2000, DV2000, DV1000, V2000, M2000 motherboard block diagram. Here we are explaining the CPU with VRM and CPU thermals. CPU required the power, so there is a VRM section which gives the supply to the CPU as per its required. Then the clock generator also gives the frequency to the CPU. North Bridge is also there. You have seen the North Bridge. North Bridge is a big IC near to the CPU. North Bridge then again connected with the CRT port. So what is an introduction to board is you have to identify the component first, then we can go ahead. The RAM is also connected with the North Bridge and display section is also connected with North Bridge. And the here backside South Bridge is connected hard disk, Wi-Fi, audio, LAN, PCI, all are connection with the help of South Bridge. The whole board connection will be like this, CPU, North Bridge, South Bridge. North Bridge is connected with maybe graphic IC and directly connected, and some RAM is also there, CPU, clock generator. South Bridge also have this type of connection and IOIC parallel keyboard. Different ICs used in different motherboards, laptops. Primary, secondary, like that. The main manufacturer are Max, RT, Texas Instruments and ISL. We can count of ICs dot will be like this, ABCD 1234. If you want to count this dot, then A9, like that we can count the signals it is. Small ICs also we can address like this, D9 or something. Welcome to our students. This is laptop third module, laptop chip level repairing training, chapter 3. Basic working detail of motherboard power stage. Basic how the motherboard power on. what the different power required, and what is the stage of laptop motherboard. We will explain this thing here. Another is an octal number system. Base is equal to 8. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No 8, no 9. Only 7 digit, from 0 to 7 digit. That is an 8 characters are there, 8 numbers are there. Address bus, where the data, from where to where the data has to be transferred, that is going. Data means 8 bit, 16 bit, 32 bit, the data will be passed. And control means voltage, and the signals are the control bus. Then again Southbridge will send a high to low signal to power IC. Then power IC will give the signals to regulator ICs, VRM ICs, all ICs. After power good getting, then he will give the signal to Northbridge about the power good signals. All these signals passing is called a handshaking signals. Nowadays new CPUs required 3-4 different voltage, and older CPU required only one voltage. In a new motherboard, the CPU is also connected with the RAM, and in some motherboards you will find the CPU is also controlling the graphic ICs. Further, Southbridge is connected with the card reader, and card reader to run, it's also required the voltage 3 watt, PCI slot 3 watt, Wi-Fi slot, touchpad required 5 watt, keyboard required 3 watt, like that. All these components required different powers. Another is the same stage, Hibernate. Working as a standby only, but Hibernate will be shut down the laptops and store all the data in the hard disk as a file. Standby stage, there will be a 3 watt, 5 watt, 2.5, 1.5. We can say SUS, or in some case it is written as a S3 also. Laptop CMOS battery give the power. To whom? RTC, real time clock, BIOS chip, Southbridge, some portions getting power. RTC CMOS is connected.
For the BGA, we have a 3 different BGA. This is your ZMR5860. That is an 870. And these are the 862, old one. These are the infrared. In this, we have a lamp. And the red infrared is there. No air pressure is there. Here is also infrared are there. But here also infrared. And here is a blower with IRDA. Base heaters are there. Blower is there, bottom blower is there, and top blower is there. So this is a BGA machine what we are using in the repairing and training, and we also sell these machines also. As a budget, whatever you want. If you have low budget, you go for this machine. That is an 862++ with a bottom heater. If you have an high medium budget, then you can take this one. And one more model is there. That is on our another center, that is a ZX-C1 or ZX-C2. You can buy the ZX-C1-C2 also. This is infrared lamp. With the infrared, the base heater is also heating, and from top the lamp is giving the heating. This is normal 870 infrared, and this is an highest BGA machine. That is a ZMR5860 we are using. These are the repairing instrument what we require to repair. First of all, for the soldering, we require these instruments. That is, we are using ATEN A356. This is with the blower and with the micro iron. Both are the common. We can use whatever we want, soldering or BGA. For that, we will use nozzles for revolving. This is a micro iron, small one micro iron for the bit. Small one, if you require this, we can use this. If you require this, we can use this. These are the tools what we are using for the chip level repairing, normal tools. This is a third eye where we can put the wire or something. We can use a magnifier also. If you want to third hand, these tools says as a third hand tools. Okay. So these are the third hand tools. Then we are using the multimeter. We have a three type of multimeters: analog, digital, and advanced for testing the frequency, diode, capacitors, and all those. We are using advanced instruments also. Different balls we are using. See, these are the very small balls are there. This size is point, different size balls are coming. it is a 0.05, and these are different size, 0.35, 0.4, 0.6, 0.76. And this is a flux. We are using a flux, heavy flux, QSI solder flux. Maybe we can use any flux, but it is a high quality flux. Okay. So this is a stencil stand where we will use the stencil. These are the different stencils. You can check different stencils. We are using the BIOS programmer. We have different BIOS programmers. First of all, there is a nano BIOS, small one. After that, we have used the L90 also. These have some advantage also and some disadvantages also. It supports some common EEPROM ICs only. And if you are going advanced machine, we are going to the Super Pro, that is a model 600P, that is a Zeltec, and another is a Flash Pro. Next portion, we are using the slot testers. These are the slot testers. In a slot tester, first of all, we will see the CPU slot tester. You can see the CPU slot tester with LED, without LED. These are with LED. Here you can check the RAM slot tester, RAM DDR2 and DDR3 of the desktops, DDR1 for the laptop. Okay, PCI slot tester. Again, DDR1, 2, 2 and 3 slot testers with LED, without LED. And now the testing instruments, we are using Tektronix TDS-1001 CRO. That is, we have an old one. Now the Chinese CRO is also coming. Victor VC-2000. Okay, frequency counters and all those things is coming. See, these we are using a Victor for the frequency counter. Then we are using the power supply unit to give the power to the laptop. Okay, the original ARTS is there, and A10 power supply is also coming. We can connect the converters, whatever we want. We will remove the converters. What the probe we want, we will use, remove from here, and we will connect on this.
MOSFETs used switching and linear regulator. This is N-channel MOSFET is connected with the drain, source and gate. And its symbol will be like this. This is N-channel MOSFET. Drain connected to diode through the cathode and source connected to diode anode. There is a two type of channel MOSFET, N-channel and P-channel MOSFETs. In one N-channel and P-channel, we have to put the black probe and red probe alternate to gate to drain and drain to gate. So gate to source and source to gate. There will be a no beep or no value, means MOSFET is maybe okay. We will show you the practical how the we check the MOSFETs. There is a control gate. We will put the MOSFET on the trainer kit, and we will give the supply to the gate. 0 watt. We will put give the 5 watt to the drain. The output will be the 0. In a dual channel MOSFET, maybe N channel, maybe P channel, are divided like this. One source, one gate and two drain for one. One source two, gate two and drain two. So these are the dual MOSFETs. These are old, and in some laptop you will find this type of MOSFETs. You can see the source are connected, drain are connected, and one gate is different. Any IC will give the enable signal to the gate, the power, maybe 2 watt, 3 watt, 4 watt, depending on the input and output. The 3.3 is a drain. Here is a fixed 3.3. When it gives a 2 watt power, the output will be low or fast. 3 watt, 4 watt depend on the output. In the desktop motherboard, the driver ICs will be there. And driver IC will enable these two MOSFET, that is a high MOSFET and low MOSFETs. It's giving high. When it's giving high, it is low. When this low, this is high. Like that, alternate signals is coming. And due to this, this signal is coming like this. Here is a 12 watt and here is a ground is connected and output is going to the coil. And from here, 1.5 watt is there. In different motherboards, different same concepts are there. You have to see the enable signals. This is its schematic diagram. You can see here the dual MOSFET, that is a PQ101. Here also you can see this is a PQ104, PQ101. Understanding the power on sequence of laptop motherboards. Now when the customers or when the users press the power button, this signal NBS1 high is coming on the power button, that is a 3 watt or 5 watt high volt is coming to the power button. When the customer press the power button, this high sort with the ground, means high become a low for 2 seconds, 3 seconds, depend on the timing. This high become a low, then this IOIC or EC or power IC understand that the high become a low means the signal is generating. From CPU, VID signal will be coming as a feedback signal. Through VID, the VRM IC, regulator IC, understand how much power to be supplied to the CPU core. And then it will generate the CPU core as per its requirement. If all this process is okay, then again here same voltage will go to the power IC, that the VRM section is okay. CPU also getting the power when it is going on the on state. So CPU set as a CPU VC core, VGA core means graphic IC also getting the power when run on. Here VRN on signal is coming from the power controller, then only this VRM IC will start working. HP 1000 watts. It also has same concept AC and DC. AC means adapter, signal name is a PV adapter and PV back. VADPL, the charger is connected, then the PV back is a main win voltage, here we can say PV back. This is Dell Inspiron N5010. Here also we can see this is a sequence how the motherboard starts, that is adapter, okay, adapter battery. I will zoom it. One adapter is connected and battery is connection. Here both the combined, the power SRC is there. That is win power SRC. In some motherboards you will see the power on sequence. Here is some power on sequence. First RTC VC is from low to high, then PCH RTC power SRC 3.3 5 watt enable, step by step signals from where it is coming, this is also written.